Hey guys, Andrew and Axonalis here, and here's my best friend Harley, our little puppy here. We'll have another video about transports, flying platforms versus a transport. Sometimes the games get kind of long, so you need a furry friend to lighten up the mood. She'll stay here a good while if you give her some treats, and she'll lick your fingers and everything. She's a good little crazy. She'll lick. All right, you can go now. I can stay, I don't care. But yeah, so we're gonna do fighting platforms versus transport. But first, we have to get to our sponsor, which is Case Knives. Nothing better than a case knife to open a booster pack. It's just really good, sharp, quality content. This one here is a toothpick. Nice thin blade, very low profile. You just love to have those. And this one's more of a Swiss Army, has all these different kind of contractions, which are all great for opening different types of booster packs you might have. But yeah, so we'll dive into this. So the main difference between fighting platforms and transports is that this has the ability to carry soldiers. So like this guy can carry a soldier, and it has a fighting platform. This is the American version, but it has the same ability. And so whenever it's attacking, so you could actually move this guy up. Here, let's say it was a bazooka guy. You can move it up here and he could shoot one away real quick because this has a speed of 4 and it has high gear, so it can go up to 6 spaces. So this is a great way to get your infantry right into the battle. Or you could have him attack that 88 or this machine gun team. He's a greenhorn, but he's good at close range. That's the great thing about a transport. But the thing is, it costs 6 IPCs, so that's like you're losing a unit to have a vehicle. What I've noticed, whenever you're playing with your friends and they see a transport, whether it's a truck, a big truck, or a little truck, and they see them carrying a unit, it's a 2-for-1. What I mean by that is you shoot it, you destroy the truck, it has very low armor, has armor of 2. And so you can easily kill that with almost anything anti-armor. And then you're down, you lose your truck, which is 6, and then you lose a troop, and so you lost 10 IPCs. And you're not able to return fire because this can't hit any medium or light tanks. And so the other thing is our big trucks like this one. This one has the ability where it has large transport. It can carry up to 1 artillery. And it can carry 1 infantry, so it can carry 2. This is a great way to move around troops fast. But this has even weaker armor, so almost anything can kill it. This is only really needed for big maps and you have to stay hidden. Another thing you have to worry about with these trucks, if you are playing with airplanes can easily kill all this, and it's just really hectic. Airplanes are really very overpowered in this game, where they can just come and flank you out of nowhere. It just doesn't make sense. So you have to protect them through hiding them behind buildings. There's a use for them. The only time I ever use them is whenever I'm in Russia. The T-34s have ability where they can transport infantry. And so you buy a T-34, it's a tank. It's not going to be one shot at it most of the time, and so infantry is pretty safe on the back of it. That's the only time I like them, or you have to be very strategic that you don't get killed by a plane or anything, because they're fun to shoot at when you play this game. But yeah, that was a comment, was what's the difference between a transport and a fighting platform. Fighting platform basically means you can fire your infantry, are able to fire transport vehicles, you can't fire. So they're kind of vulnerable. They can't return fire or anything, and it's a cat and mouse game when you have transports in your game. So that's one of the reasons you could get a bunch of transports, but it's just a risky game, and every unit matters in this game, so a lot of times we just stick with tanks. But thanks guys, y'all have a good one.